US President Donald Trump announced his intention to revoke Hong Kong's preferential treatment as a separate customs and travel territory from the rest of China in response to Beijing's recent move to protect national security through new legislation for the Special Administrative Region. The US may impose tariffs on Hong Kong's exports and impede Hong Kongers wishing to obtain an American visa. Trump's plan is intended to punish China, but the US itself may turn out to be the biggest loser from the decision.
President Trump has to take some kind of a firm signal in terms of the Hong Kong situation, but doing so actually will hurt American companies more than it hurt China.
Numbers explain why. The US share in Hong Kong's global trade stood at only 6.2% in 2019. That's compared with the mainland's 50.8%, China's Taiwan's 5%, Japan's 4.4%, and Singapore's 4.3%. Even if the US ends its special trading relationship with Hong Kong, the city still has multiple alternatives. Moreover, Hong Kong's exports to the US made up only 7.7% of its total in 2019. This means US new tariffs would exert limited impact on the city. If Hong Kong retaliates, the world's largest economy could end up losing out. The US has long had a substantial trade surplus with Hong Kong, around $297 billion between 2009 and 2018. According to Hong Kong's Trade and Industry Department, in 2018, the city was the United States' third largest export market for wine, fourth largest for beef, and seventh largest for all agricultural products. Should preferential policies for those goods disappear, American farmers would bear the brunt. American businesses would also suffer losses. As reported by the Wall Street Journal, the US has more than 1,300 companies, around 85,000 citizens, about 300 regional headquarters and 400 regional offices in Hong Kong. Apple and FedEx are among those operating in the city. These businesses would be the first to be affected if Washington strips Hong Kong of its special status.
Clearly, American companies that operate in the territory are going to be impacted. The US-China Business Council expressed grave concern about where things were heading with regards to Hong Kong's status as a global financial hub.
Hong Kong's reputation as a global financial hub is a result of policy support from the mainland. It is not granted by the United States. The central government's one country, two systems principle has guaranteed a high level of autonomy in Hong Kong. This is the prerequisite to the city's sustained growth. In addition, mainland companies have instilled fresh momentum to Hong Kong's prosperity. According to Xinhua, at the end of 2019, mainland-related firms accounted for more than half of the total enterprises listed in Hong Kong, contributing 73.3% of market capitalization and 82.5% of turnover. Trump could undeniably negatively impact the city if he follows through on the threat, but only to a limited extent. It is American businesses and farmers who would suffer the most. Trump should have the wisdom to understand this approach would be self-defeating.